members of management present here this morning. I recognize our professors, members of staff, king and queen makers. I want to recognize especially the kings and queens in the house this morning. No eye has seen, no ear has heard. It has not entered into the heart of man what God has in stock for you. God has something special he wants to do with your life. We have not seen your type before. The companies that you will create, we have not seen such before. They are new. They are dynamic. They are explosive. They are about to happen. The Bible says the whole world waits in eager expectation for the manifestation of the sons of God. We are still waiting for those things that God wants to do through your life, and those things will come to pass in the name of Jesus. No devil can stop those things from coming to pass. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you are the one I'm talking about, shout the loudest hallelujah. You know, some things are already burning inside you. I have on my table presently the business card of a student, 400 level, EIE. What? Was discussing business. Was discussing. I won't mention the name so that. And that's not the only one. As I was talking, another one in computer science said, wow, this is what I'm thinking about. You know, I want us to discuss great ideas. Great. When I see people with vision, you know, I don't know when time goes. A student in 500 level chemical engineering, you know, she's a precious daughter, came one day and we're talking vision. And I didn't know when hours passed. Vision. 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 Excuse me, you are in 300 level. Where are you going with your life? As in, what are you, praise God, where are you going? Are you trying to answer the question or it's funny? Okay, praise God. I listened to a song. Someone will say, what was he talking about? Just who come with the Holy Spirit? And where you are seated is already teaching you what he wants you to know for the moment. A student, Joshua Ayoade, wrote a song. I said, wow, which kind of a song is this? Gifted. Then upon inquiry, I discovered that the producer was in the choir. And I saw him, said, what? You produce that music here? You know what I'm talking about? The truth is that here seated this morning are gifts, you know, potentials that God wants to do something with. How many of you are seated here and it has occurred to you that things are not going the way they should in this country? You just feel, you know, it has entered into you. There's a student here who is making money from agric, from a particular agri. He has a farm. What's the name of that farm? I'll remember the name. You know, as in, he has a name for it already, and the farm is working, even though he's in school. He's in school right now. I'm talking about him. Where is he? God's care firms. Say, what? And that's what the chancellor has been talking about. Someone say, what is he saying? He says, you preach. Yes, is this part of it? The summary of it all is that it's a new dawn for you. In realms where you have not operated before, you find yourself operating there. It's a new dawn for you. It's a new dawn for you. Hallelujah. On Tuesday, we began looking at a title for our chapel services for this week, and that is Abiding in the Realm of New Dawn Blessings. How many were blessed at Shiloh? Hallelujah. I was blessed. I am blessed. Hallelujah. Abiding in the realm of new dawn blessings. John chapter 15, verse 1 to 5. John chapter 15. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me there beareth not fruit, it taketh away. And every branch that bears fruit, that is productive, he purgeth it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Hey, he said, you know, if the word of God has been coming towards you, cleaning you, removing some things, it's so that you can bear more fruit. He said, now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken to you. Verse 4. Please, can we read verse 4 together? Abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye, except ye abide in me. I am the vine. Ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in me, and in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. Abiding in the realm of new dawn blessings. People are always excited when they have the privilege of leaving the shores of Nigeria. In fact, people have a way of celebrating you. Once you just say, so yesterday I traveled out. They don't want to know where you traveled out. You traveled out. Even if it is Somalia, sorry, I shouldn't mention any nation. Even if it is that nation, you travel, whatever nation, travel out. God's servant said, if someone stops at, is it Ajegunle that I used in the example, and begins to say, UK, free of charge. Say, you see people with PhD marching inside. And people who are so lawless in Nigeria, when they get to a place like the US, the UK, you know, where the law is strongly upheld, you see them behaving themselves. Because you don't abide by the law, you are deported immediately. In fact, they won't wait for when there is flight going to your country. The first flight going to your continent. So whether you're from Nigeria, it doesn't matter. If it is Niger that they can just drop you somewhere. Deported. So you see people who will evade tax in Nigeria, they don't play with it though. You abide by the law. By the law. The truth is that where you are now is not where you used to be. That if you were a part of Shiloh, I'm too sure. Where you are now is not where you used to be. Something has happened. Something has happened. You have been catapulted from the old realm into the new realm. From an old way into a new dawn. Something is new. The truth is, that thing that is new is actually basically, you know, centrally speaking, in your spirit. And we need to talk about it so that you don't lose it. You must have heard people say things like spiritual truths are slippery. If you are not careful, some of these things, you know, you need to hold them dear to your heart. You need to play the messages again to keep your mind where it should be. The Bible says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Why? You need to renew your mind because your mind is older than your spirit, so to say. Because your spirit got born again a few years ago. Some of you were born some 20 years ago. Your mind speaks loud in your life. You need to renew it. You need to bring your mind in subjection to the word of God so that your mind can think in a way that will favor the flourishing of your spirit. So to stay in a nation, you need to abide by the laws. Also to stay in the realm of new dawn blessings, to abide there, there are things you must do. There are things you must do. There are responsibilities. Responsibilities. You don't abide in a nation by your age. It's not by your gender. It's by complying to the laws. What are those laws that we must comply with to remain where he has placed us? The truth is, a lot of Christians don't know where they are. And the truth is, it's possible to carry a grace, it's possible to carry a blessing and still suffer as if you don't carry such a blessing. Kenneth Hagin was saving money in the inner jean of his pocket, wanted to use it to buy a gift for his wife, and was at a filling station, wanted to buy fuel, and he wasn't holding cash. He had money at home, but it wasn't with him. So he had to call an elder in the church, "Please help me bring money to buy fuel so that I will be able to move this car. When I get home, I'll give you back the money." Only after going through all that stress, only to discover that there was money in his pocket that he could have used. You might be someone, but you might be someone loaded with a particular power, but you can suffer for the lack of it if you don't know that you have it. A lot of Christians don't know where they are seated. You are seated in Christ, far above all principalities and powers. That is where you are. That is who you are. But you don't know. Some people don't know. Some people don't know. So what are those laws that we must abide by? Number one, the law of constant fellowship. The law of consistent fellowship. The law of consistent fellowship. Acts chapter 6, verse 1 to 4. The law of consistent fellowship. There are many people here who have accelerated and overtaken the people that got born again before them. It doesn't matter when you got born again. What you do after you become born again matters a lot. The law of consistent fellowship. Acts chapter 6, verse 1 to 4. Something happened in the first church in those days, when the number of the disciples was multiplied, there arose a murmuring of the Grecians against the Hebrews because their widows were neglected in the daily ministration. Verse 3. Wherefore, brethren, no, the disciples said, okay, verse 2, sorry. Then the 12 called the multitude of disciples unto them and said, "It is no reason that we should leave the word of God and serve tables." In other words, we can't leave the word of God. Other people can leave it. We can't leave the word of God. He said, "Look for brethren among you, seven men of honest report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business." Verse 4. "But we will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word." But we will give ourselves continuously to prayer and to the ministry of the word. You know what the disciples were saying here? Saying others can leave the word of God for something else. He said, but not us. Others can leave the word for other things, but not us. Not us. Not us. Acts chapter 8, verse 1. Because these things have repercussion. Your consistent fellowship is what tells how good your relationship is with God. You know, there are people. No, I didn't say three. Acts chapter 8. Now, the stronger your fellowship with the Holy Spirit, the stronger your Christian life, the stronger your faith. There are people that approach God always. Every time you approach God in prayers, it's, "Lord, so I want you to give me." You go to God always with prayer points. But you should go beyond that level of just approaching every day with prayer points. Lord, this is what I want you to do. This is what I want you to do. In Acts chapter 13, verse 1, the Bible says there were prophets, some prophets and teachers gathered there in Antioch, and the Bible says they were worshiping the Lord and fasting. Hey, they were worshiping and fasting. They were worshiping and fasting. A lot of people fast with the intention that when I fast, I will get this from God. But the better way, you know, the still more excellent way is to fast for fellowship. Like the song that the choir sang. Can I have someone on the keyboard? Like the song that the choir sang. I want to be where you were. I want to be where you are just going and just singing the song. Others are saying other things. It doesn't concern you. That's just what you are looking for. I want to be where you are. I want to be where you are. Hallelujah. I want to be where you are. There's a song I can't forget, you know. And it's just one sentence from beginning to the end. Just to be close to you. Just to be close to you. Do you know the song? Just to be close to you is my desire. That's the end of the song. Just to be close to you. Just to be close to you. Just to be close to you is my desire. I think it's Alvin Slaughter. Just to be close to you.
Oh, just to be close to you.
Just to be close to you.
Oh,
just to be close to you.
Oh,
it's my desire. Just to be close. I want to be where you were.
Dwelling in your presence. Feasting on your table.
Feasting on your table.
Surrounded by your glory.
Surrounded by your glory. In your presence. Do you want to sing that song?
That's where I always want to be. I just want to be with you.
Has it ever happened to you that you were in a service and someone called you, tapped you, and you felt grieved in your spirit? Why did you call me now? When I see some things in church, or when I hear some things, it's just an evidence, a proof that there was no connection in the first place. One day I went to teach Wolfby in church in town. And then in between classes, I was meditating. Pastor Andrew was the assistant resident pastor then. So I was in his office. Then his wife was there with his baby. His wife was there. Then she was bringing out, the last I remember was that she was bringing out a food flask to eat. But I was meditating. I was following a particular scripture. I was deep. I was somewhere else. Then when I came back, It now occurred to me that it looked as if I had a sound. So I asked her, I said, were you asking me to come and eat? He said, yes. I said, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. She said, I know. A lot of people are too shallow in their relationship and their relationship with God, and they are encouraging others to do the same. You know, when you are in that kind of realm, there are some things you can't see. When you are living in an atmosphere of this fellowship with the Holy Spirit, there are some things you don't want to see. One day, I was in a computer room in my former place of work. You know, I was not watching anything. I was just in the computer room. Then I looked towards a particular screen and someone was watching something there. And the thing just affected me straight. What? I'm saying there is a realm. I don't know. Maybe you have not seen it before. Or maybe you were there and you left. No, those ones are not good. But I just hope that's where you live. I just hope that's where you live. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Fellowship with God. It will change your life. It will change everything about you. It will change your temperament. It will break addictions. It will transform you. You know one of the reasons why some people say they are not enjoying their Christian lives? Because they don't always fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Like Pastor Zebre taught the other time, he was teaching us, and he mentioned some people using, depending, it's not wrong to use daily bread, depending on daily bread. Not daily bread in the Bible, as in devotional guide. It's good to be guided devotionally. But there are human beings here that if you ask them, please give me devotionals that I can use for next week, it will sit down here, connect with the Holy Spirit, write on 7 topics and give you, go and use it for 7 days. Why can't you get for one day for yourself? Fellowship. Psalm 1 verse 1 to 3. He said, blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the wicked, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Bible says, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. And in his law doth he meditate. When? Day and night. It shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. In other words, your life will not be dry. Your life will not be dry. It's dangerous to live a dry life. Your life will not be dry. He said, his leaves also shall not wither. He said, whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Hey, abide in the vine. Abide, abide. Abide in the vine. Hallelujah. He said, I'm the vine, you are the branches. That shows you that what flows through the vine is what flows into the branches. That's what you carry. Hallelujah. This law of fellowship is very important. In the word of God and in prayers. In worship to the Most High. That's number one. Number two, the second law. The law of unwavering faith in the New Dawn prophetic declaration. The law of unwavering faith. Unwavering faith. Unwavering faith. In 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 20, Joseph had made a statement. He said, believe in God. He said, so shall you be established. Believe his prophet, so shall ye prosper. Wow. The law of unwavering faith. Every time you waver, you step out of the new dawn. Romans chapter 4 verse 20 talks about Abraham. He said he staggered not at the promise of God. He said he did not stagger. I like that. True unbelief. Unbelief makes people to stagger. James chapter 1 verse 5. He said a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways. He said, let him not think that he will receive anything from God. Yes, but let him ask in faith, not wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. Verse 7. Let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. The law of unwavering faith. Stop wavering. In Matthew chapter 14. In Matthew chapter 14. Peter asked Jesus in verse 28. You know, they saw him walking on the sea, walking on water. And Peter asked him, if it is you, Peter answered him, Lord, if it be thou, bid me come. You know, there are times in your life when you don't understand the reason why a particular miracle didn't happen, so to say, that you expected. There are times when you don't understand the reason why something happened somewhere. You don't understand. Those are delicate times when you need to be focused and you need to know who you believe. Charles and Francis Alter, they made a statement. If we lay hands on 500 people, let's assume that nothing happened. He said we will go on and lay hands on the 501st person again. Why? Because the Bible says so. Hello, faith is actually unwavering confidence in the word of God. You leave every other thing. Whether he walks or whether he looks as if he's not. God says so. That is what I'm going for. That is faith. That is faith. Because the truth is that there are some things you don't understand. Someone might have, for example now, if I'm supposed to be resting, the law of Sabbath, the law of resting, and I'm not resting, when I should rest, and something that happens, you now feel, what is happening to his health? Some people will now be saying, God, where is your face? No, it's not God, where is your face? Something has happened, but you didn't know. Sometimes we allow things that we don't know anything about to destabilize our faith. Look at it. Please put that scripture on the screen. Matthew chapter 14, verse 28. So if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water. And in verse 29. And he said, come. Hey, that's what you need. That is the beginning of faith. When God has not spoken, there is no faith anywhere. That come, that word come, is the beginning of faith. And when Peter was come down of the ship, he walked on the water. Hey, I love that. He walked on the water to go to Jesus. You know, we live in a world where there are critics and there are observers. Dangerous observers. People preach about this message. They say Peter walked on water and people blame him and say he began to sink. Yes, but first of all, before blaming Peter, that why did he sink? Let us acknowledge the faith of Peter. Which other disciple walked on water? Which other disciple walked on water? He walked on. Please put that scripture there, sir. And when Peter was come down, from this morning henceforth, new things will begin to happen in your new dawn life. The things that people thought will never be possible, such will be the order of the day in your life. In the name of Jesus. Hey, and when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water. Peter is in the cloud of witness now and is hearing this. Wow. You know, I'm just imagining what was he thinking? I want you to imagine yourself on the water. If you were Peter, what would you be thinking on water? He walked on the water to go to Jesus. Next. But that is what I'm preaching against in the name of Jesus. I'm preaching against the buts. Because there are times in life when the boats approach. Say, but when he saw the wind boisterous, you know, hello, a faith-filled man living in a doubt-filled world will soon carry a deflated faith. Watch your environment. You don't listen to everybody. There are some. It's possible that there are some people. Kneel down. Like that drama that the Joy Company did at Shiloh. Kneel down. Some people don't believe. You can't listen to them. They will affect your faith. Protect your faith. Guard your heart with all diligence. For from it are the issues of life. Guard your heart. If you want to retain your place in the new dawn realm, please leave that scripture on the screen. When he saw the wind, as he was seeing the wind, he was not seeing the word come again. It was the word come that brought him. It was the word of God that brought him. He was afraid. I'm beginning to sink. That's what happens. When you begin to see what you should not see, you begin to sink. He cried, saying, Lord, save me. He did the right thing. I don't know if anybody is here. Your faith is sinking. You are coming out this morning. What happened? No, that's where people stopped. People just conclude and say, Peter sank. No. Verse 31. And immediately, Jesus stretched forth his hand and caught him. He didn't carry him. He caught him. He reconnected to the vine. And he came back upon the water. Hey, I don't know if you can imagine what was happening on the water that day. And caught him and said unto him, O thou of little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt? Verse 32. And when they were come into the ship. What's the meaning? The meaning is that after Jesus stretched forth his hand, he held him and they were walking together on water. Yes. They have laughed at you before. But those same people will soon see your testimony again. In the name of Jesus, the law of unwavering faith. Say, I believe. We live in a world where people play with some faith nuggets. It is well, low. It is well, low. It's not even well, it's sounding well. It's well. It is well that brought back the daughter, the son of that Shunammite woman to life. It is well. It is well. It is well. Hallelujah. Watch what you say with your mouth. Numbers chapter 14, verse 28. The word of God said, God said unto Moses, said, surely as I live, as these people have said in my ears, so will I do unto them. Hey! Do you know what they said? They said they were like grasshoppers before the enemies. Do you know that God was patient enough? It is a law. God was patient enough. God allowed them to wander around and wait and relax until all the people that didn't believe, until all of them died. Because without faith, you can't enter your promised land. There is something God has been revealing to you. It began maybe during catching the vision of God for your life. It began that month. And you are saying, is it possible? How can this be real? Excuse me. Don't talk negative. Believe and it will come to pass. One of the proofs that is a divine vision is that it's bigger than what your own hand can do by yourself. Don't carry that kind of vision to someone that has never taken a step towards any vision, lest they kill it for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 2 Kings chapter 7 verse 2. A professor of economics said to Elisha, he said, what is your prophetic declaration? That the Lord will turn this around. They will be buying something for so price. He said, it's not possible. He said, can it happen? He said, if the Lord will make windows in heaven, might this thing be? Oh, yeah. And he said, behold, thou shalt see it with thy eye. You know, it's a curse to see it and not touch it. It's a curse. It's a curse to see and not. He saw it and he didn't touch it. He was not wise. He could have begged the prophet, say, sir, please forgive my ignorant utterance. Please forgive. He didn't beg. That was how he died. I don't know how the people around that man felt. We are this top man in government. They weren't there when he spoke that word. It's a law. You want to eat out of that prophetic declaration? Believe it. Don't speak against it. Unwavering faith. Someone wrote a book and titled it "Saying to See." Saying to See. Someone came to preach during my service there in Abuja. I can't forget the title of that message. What's the title of the message? Talk. Say, a closed mouth is a closed destiny. Number three, the law of obedience to divine instructions. Genesis chapter 3, verse 23 to 24. The law of obedience to divine instructions. Adam lost Eden to disobedience. Genesis chapter 3, verse 23 to 24. Therefore, the Lord God sent him forth from the garden into Eden to till the ground from whence it was taken. Verse 24. So he drove out the man. See, there is something called shame that follows disobedience. They said, do it like this. You said, no. There's something called shame. He chased him out. A student was given an opportunity to confess, and he didn't confess. How did you feel when we were going behind him? He was now caught. He didn't know that we have evidence against him. He was now caught. Where's the purse? He told us where the purse was. We are now following him. And he was following. And the owner of the purse was behind. And you are going. And it is obvious that you are the one that stole the purse. And, Kai. And I was looking at him. I said, Kai, this is shame. There are a lot of people here, you carry colorful destinies, but if you can open your eyes and see with the eyes of truth, you realize that there is a spot upon that destiny now because of what you touched, because of where you went, because of what you did. Never you think that it's only youths that are tempted. No, it's a general thing. And it's a personal decision that will make you take your stand and say, no, I'm not going for this. I'm standing by the truth, in the truth. After Jesus was tempted of the devil, you know, the Bible says the devil left him for a season. The law of obedience. The law of obedience. John 14, 15, if you love me, you will keep my command. And finally, the last law. The law of praiseful lifestyle. 2 Kings chapter 3, verse 15. They brought Elisha to prophesy. They didn't know that all that he was doing was not by power, not by might. It's by the Spirit of God. He told them, bring me a minstrel. Hey, and it came to pass when the minstrel played that the hand of the Lord came upon him. Hey, in a place where there is the worship of God, the hand of God is not scarce. The hand of God is not scarce. Oh, that's why this evening is praise jamboree. I won't be spending my life. We will take attendance for one reason. You know, I like to take attendance for some reasons. And those attendance, I won't come after you. There is an attendance that student affairs will take. The attendance that registry will take, ask student affairs to take. Now, fine. Chaplaincy will forward it like that. Apart from the punishment that will come to anybody that is not there or something, the reason why I'm interested in attendance. What is it? Hallelujah. The reason why I'm interested in such attendance is that I want to know how many people are actually plugging into what is happening here. I want to know. One day I saw people sitting at the back. And I went to the back. As I was going to the back, they were standing up. I wasn't going to make you. I wanted to see your face. I know how many people I pray for upstairs. I know how many testimonies I've seen. I know only few that have testified. that God is good. I want to see the face of, perhaps is there an ungrateful person there that is not grateful to God? I want to see. One day it was departure service because people were going home. Someone suddenly lost regard for God and was misbehaving. And I thought in my heart, I said, is it not God that will take you home safely that you are misbehaving in his presence? Hey, let's honor God. Let's honor God. Let's honor God. Eli and his two children, they died the same day. He said, they that honor me, I will honor. They that honor me, I will honor. He said, I have said that your family will continue before me forever. He said, but not anymore. Not anymore. Do you know that God changes his mind? He will not change his mind against you in the name of Jesus Christ. You didn't hear that? He will not change his mind against you. He said, I have said that initially the plan was that maybe the book that is called 1 Samuel today will have been Hophni. The book that is called 2 Samuel will have been Phinehas. But God removed Eli and put Samuel there because there was no honor. My life must honor God. My life must honor God. I sense in my spirit that there are people here. All eyes closed, all eyes bowed as we close. There are people here. It's a glorious destiny, yes. But you have toiled with disobedience. What he says you should not do, that's what you have been doing. You are in relationships that you should not be. You are doing things that you should not be doing. But there is a privilege for you this morning to return to Jesus. You want to return to him? Can you please raise your hand above your head? I want to pray with you. Just raise your hand above your head. You're saying, Lord, I want you to take this spot away. I want you to take this shame away. I want you to restore me. I want to pray with you. Where you are seated, just raise your hand above your head. Yes, 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 yes. Raise the hand. Say, Lord, I'm stepping out of that shame into honor. Raise it very well. 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 If you are raising it, raise it very well. God bless that hand. Any other person, you raise it very well. Raise it. Say, Lord, I'm stepping out. I surrender all to you in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for every hand. Sorry, are you lifting that hand? I want to be sure. If you're raising it, raise it very well. If you're not lifting it, so that we can go. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I pray for every hand raised this morning. God bless that hand. Father, I ask for restoration in the name of Jesus. Let your mercy prevail. Let your mercy prevail. And let the lost glory in this life be restored. In the name of Jesus Christ. Ushers, please put a paper in the hand so that the person can see me in the office later on. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. Can you wave the hand so that they can see you? Father, we give you praise. In Jesus' precious name. You won't lose your new dawn realm. You won't lose it. You won't lose it. You won't lose it. In the name of Jesus. I'd like to just rise to your feet and pray in the Holy Ghost. Say, Lord, I won't lose it. I won't fall out of it. I won't fall out of it. In the name of Jesus Christ. I won't fall out of it. I won't fall out of it. I won't fall out of this new realm where you have placed me. In it is your security. In it is your preservation. Say, Lord, I won't fall out of it. Are you praying at all? Pray in the Spirit for 10 seconds. Say, I won't fall out of it. I won't fall out of it. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. You are covered with the blood of Jesus. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. You will not fail. You will not faint. You will not fall in the name of Jesus Christ. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. And we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord. forever and ever. Amen. Peace. Before we share the covenant greetings, please remember Praise Jamboree. Please come focused. Don't allow anybody to distract you, because the balance of your blessings will be landing in your lives in the name of Jesus Christ. It's 6 p.m.